This is Neily on nutrition. Saturated fats, unsaturated fats, mono, poly, what does this all mean? That's what we're going to talk about today, in addition to the next couple of videos. We talked about the lipid family. So there are three main components of the lipid family, the sterols, the phospholipids, and triglycerides. Triglycerides make up 95% of the lipid family, so that's what we're going to be spending the majority of our time talking about, and that's our focus today. So let's get started, all right? You ready? Okay. So a triglyceride, and we abbreviate that TG, is made up of a backbone of glycerol and three fatty acids. Now, in comparison to the building blocks of protein, amino acids, or the monosaccharides, which make up our carbohydrates, the triglycerides are a much larger, more complex molecule, and this is why. So, but first of all, the glycerol backbone, this is the glycerol molecule. It's a very small molecule. It has three carbons, and its structure doesn't change. What changes, though, is each one of these fatty acids can be different. They can differ in a couple of ways. They can differ by their length, and they can differ by whether or not they have double bonds and a number of double bonds. So in regard to their length, they can be anywhere from 2 to 4 carbons in length, 6 to 12, or 14 to 24. And those are respectively short chain fatty acids, medium chain, and long chain fatty acids. The most common fatty acids in our diet are the long chain fatty acids. And what I have drawn here is a long chain fatty acid. It's an 18 carbon fatty acid. Now, all of the fatty acids consist of this end here, which is a methyl end and an acid end. They all contain that. What differs from fatty acid to fatty acid is how many carbons they have. That's where they can grow in length, but they all have those particular ends to them. This is an example of what we call a saturated fatty acid. And what makes it saturated? It is fully saturated with hydrogen atoms. So every single carbon here you can see has a hydrogen atom attached to it. That's what we call a saturated fatty acid. So now when we're looking at a triglyceride, the fatty acid might be a saturated fatty acid or another type of fatty acid. They're often mixed triglycerides, meaning they have different types of fatty acids attached to them. So fully saturated with hydrogen atoms. That's also what makes the saturated fats more solid at room temperature, is they don't have any what we call double bonds, which when things have more double bonds, that makes them more liquid. So our fats, not only can they vary in length, but they can vary in their level of saturation. They can be saturated, meaning they have no double bonds, or they can be unsaturated. They might have one double bond, which is a monounsaturated, or a polyunsaturated, which is two or more double bonds. So let's take a look at an example here. So this is fully saturated. Now, a monounsaturated, let's say that we don't have these two carbons, for example. Now, in the world of chemistry, there is a law of chemistry, so to speak, that there is a certain number of bonds that each atom requires. Carbon needs 4 bonds, so if we're going to take away these atoms here, we have to add a link there, and that makes each carbon here have 4 bonds, and therefore this is called a double bond. Now, this fatty acid is a monounsaturated fatty acid, okay? So that's an example of a monounsaturated. Now, if we had a unsaturated fatty acid where we're missing a couple of more hydrogens, then again, we have the link between the two to keep that structure. And so now we're missing 2 more, and we have 2 or more double bonds, and that is called a polyunsaturated fatty acid. And we can have more levels of double bonds, but that very simply shows you the difference between saturated, mono, and polyunsaturated fatty acid. Okay, so I hope that explains a little bit to you about the difference between each of the fatty acids, as I mentioned. The triglyceride, each of those fatty acids may be different. They may be differing in length, and they may be differing in their level of saturation. We're going to talk a little bit more in the next video. So that's a little bit to get you started. Thanks for watching Neily on Nutrition, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.